स्टूडेंट्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय वीडियो क्लास ऑन सॉल्विंग क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम प्रीवियस एनुअल एग्जामिनेशन क्वेश्चन पेपर्स। एज यू नो स्टूडेंट्स, यू नो वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड सॉल्विंग प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन पेपर्स फ्रॉम फोर चैप्टर्स। वी कंप्लीटेड सॉलिड स्टेट सॉल्यूशंस, अल्कोहल स्पिनोस एंड ईथर्स, एंड ऑल्सो एल्डिहाइड्स, कीटोन्स एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड्स। We finished four chapters with respect to solving question papers from previous annual examinations, right? And of course, in the today's video, I'm going to take up the electrochemistry chapter. I'm going to discuss the questions of electrochemistry chapter from previous annual examination question papers from 2014 to 2020. That is from March 2014 to July 2022. Totally, we have 14 question papers, is it not? And of course, with respect to the chapter electrochemistry, I am going to discuss questions of the chapter electrochemistry in three videos. In first and second video of this particular discussion, I am going to solve the question papers from 2014 to 20 there. In third video, I am going to discuss the questions from PU board model papers. You know, we have 10 model papers. I'm going to solve all the questions of the 10 PU board model papers, okay na, with respect to the chapter electrochemistry, right? Agudala, right? And of course, we'll start, you know, the electrochemistry there. As far as electrochemistry is concerned, you know, 9 hours allotted to this particular chapter in the syllabus. 9 hours will be allotted for this particular chapter electrochemistry. Because of that, there will be 8 marks questions from this particular chapter in annual examination. There will be 8 marks from this particular chapter in annual examination. Out of 8 marks, you know, there will be one question in part A. There will be one question in part A that carries 1 mark, and that is question number 3 of the annual examination question paper is from the chapter electrochemistry that carries 1 marks. Apart from that, you know, we have one more question, yes, in part B. In part B, you know, we have one more question, that is question number 12. That is question number 12, that is question number 12, and that carries 2 marks. That question number 12 of the question paper is from electrochemistry again. And that is one question in part B that carries 2 marks. One more question in part D. There will be one more question in part D, that is question number 29. And that carries 5 marks. That carries 5 marks. Totally 8 marks from this particular chapter. That is weightage of this particular chapter in the annual examination question paper. And as far as 5 mark questions are concerned, generally 5 mark questions, you know, it will be of 3 plus 2 type question, you know. One question will be carrying 3 marks, other question carries 2 marks. Or it can be 2 plus 2 plus 1 type question. There will be 3 questions. 2 questions carry 2 marks, 1 question carry, yes, it is 1 mark. Like that, you know, we have the distribution of the questions, you know, with respect to the electrochemistry chapter in annual examination question paper, yes. And as you know, whenever I'm discussing questions of the particular chapter, I'm going to divide all the questions of the question paper into 3 parts, you know. In first part, you know, in section A, I'm going to discuss only 1 mark questions. In section 2, I'm going to discuss only 2 mark questions. In section 3, I am going to discuss 5 mark questions. Like that, you know, the discussion continues, right? And we'll start with the section 1. Here, I am going to give the answers to 1 mark questions appeared in different question papers from March 2014 to July 2020. Yes? We'll start with the first question. Yes? We'll start with the first question. That is, this question appeared in March 2014 question paper, yes, and that is what is secondary cell anta ide first question enadu what is secondary cell nimge gottide batteries or cells will be of two types primary cells and secondary cells illi secondary cells matra ide secondary cells are rechargeable yes it is rechargeable batteries rechargeable batteries are called as secondary cells rechargeable batteries are called as secondary cells athava the batteries which can be recharged by passing current through them in opposite direction so that we can reuse them they are called as secondary cells agbodala rechargeable batteries are called as secondary cells athava batteries which can be recharged by passing electric current through them in opposite direction so that we can reuse them that is what we call it as secondary cells agbodala that is first question right we'll see the second question now right the second question appeared in July 2014 question paper right write the SI unit of molar conductivity anta ide you know molar conductivity that is represented by delta that lambda m molar conductivity is represented by lambda m its SI unit is of course Simon meter square per mole this is the SI unit of molar conductivity or it can be written as Simon meter square mole to the power minus 1 this is also another way of writing SI unit of molar conductivity we have one more unit Simon centimeter square per mole but this is not SI unit in SI unit no we have Simon meter square per mole this is the SI unit okay na why it is so anta nil kelidre that is kappa into vm because lambda m molar conductivity is equal to kappa into vm kappa is conductivity Simon per meter unit of conductivity volume of a solution containing 1 mole of electrolyte vm andre no volume of a solution containing 1 mole of electrolyte that is meter cube per mole meter cube per mole therefore we have to multiply madidre Simon meter square per mole is the SI unit of yes it is molar conductivity that is SI unit there agbodala welcome to the third question yes the third question appeared in March 2015 yes what happens to molar conductivity when 1 mole of KCl dissolved in 1 liter is diluted to 5 times the overall question is tenedu what happens to molar conductivity when dilution takes place answer is you know that molar conductivity increases molar conductivity increases upon dilution here we have 1 liter solution of KCl when it is diluted to 5 times or 10 times or 2 times or 3 times yesterday dilution madidre enagutte molar conductivity jaasti agutte yes this is the answer that is upon dilution molar conductivity increases but conductivity decreases dilution madidre conductivity kadame agutte illandre molar conductivity jaasti agutte nimige kelirudu molar conductivity agirodrinda molar conductivity increases and badra saaku that carries 1 marks okay na you see that question number 4 this question number 4 appeared in July 2015 question paper yes how many coulombs of electricity required to oxidize 1 mole of aluminium to Al3+ anta ide yes your oxidation of aluminium is expected oxidation of aluminium is represented as yes it is Al gives Al3++ 3 moles of electrons oxidation of aluminium involves loss of 3 moles of electron that is 1 mole of Al loses 3 moles of electrons you know that you are supposed to decide yes it is how many coulombs of electricity quantity of electricity you are supposed to decide how done and of course quantity of electricity is equal to yes charge of 3 moles of electrons how the Okay, one mole of Al loses 3 moles of electrons. Therefore, quantity of electricity is equal to charge of 3 moles of electrons. Charge of 3 moles of electrons is equal to what? 3 faradays. Because charge of 1 mole of electrons is 1 faraday. Charge of 3 moles of electrons is 3 faradays. And that is in coulombs you need. In faradays, now in coulombs, because 1 faraday is equal to what? 96,500 coulombs. How the? Exactly. 1 faraday is equal to 96,500 coulombs. You want to multiply, we are going to get the answer, that is 3 into 96,500. Yes, that comes out to be, yes, it is 2,89,500 coulombs. This is the quantity of electricity in coulombs required to oxidize 1 mole of aluminium into Al3 plus ions. This is what we call 2,89,500 coulombs. Coulombs alle baribeku. Faradays alle kelidre bari 3 faradays ant baradre saaku. Coulombs alle kelidodrinda 3 into 96,500 coulombs. Agbodala? That is question number 4, appeared in July 2015 question paper. Yes. Question number 5 bani. Which gas is evolved at cathode during electrolysis of aqueous solution of sodium chloride? Alli gamanisbeku. Sodium chloride, is it aqueous or molten? Adanna correct a gamanisbeku. Yes. And of course, as far as electrolysis of sodium chloride solution is concerned, you know, at cathode, H plus ions are reduced. At cathode, H plus ions are reduced to liberate hydrogen gas. At cathode, H plus ions are reduced to liberate hydrogen gas. Whereas at anode, Cl minus ions are oxidized to liberate chlorine gas. At anode, Cl minus ions are oxidized to chlorine gas. Whereas at cathode, hydrogen gas is liberated. You are supposed to name the gas that is liberated at cathode only. Hagagi, your answer is simply hydrogen gas. Anode keldre chlorine gas anta baribeku. Nimage gottide illi in the case of aqueous solution of sodium chloride, there is a competition between Na plus ions and H plus ions in order to get reduced. Adare, out of Na plus ions and H plus ions are preferably reduced, because SRP of H plus ions will be greater than SRP of Na plus ions. Therefore, H plus ions preferably reduced to liberate hydrogen gas. Nenpirli, this is in the case of, yes, it is aqueous solution of sodium chloride. Adhe molten sodium chloride anta kelidre, at cathode, sodium metal will be deposited. Adhe molten sodium chloride anta kelidre, sodium metal will be deposited at cathode anta baribeku. Anode alli, molten sodium chloride adru kuda chlorine barutte, aqueous sodium chloride adru kuda chlorine barutte, alli en problem illa. Yes, that is. Next one. Right, question number 6 there. This question number 6 appeared in July 2016. Yes. And write Nernst equation for Daniell cell. Daniell cell and Takshane. You should remember this equation, that is overall equation that is taking place in, yes, it is Daniell cell during production of electricity. Yes, that is zinc undergoes oxidation, right? Zinc undergoes oxidation to give Zn plus 2 ions, and copper ions will be reduced to copper there. This is the overall reaction that is going on in, yes, it is Daniell cell. Zinc is oxidized to Zn plus 2 ions, copper plus 2 ions are reduced to, yes, it is copper. And of course, these two are the reactants, these two are the products. How that? As far as Nernst equation is concerned, E of cell is equal to E naught of cell minus, and of course, I am writing equation at 298 kelvins. Right? That is 0.0591 divided by N anta barthiyo da. As far as N is concerned, number of electrons exchanged. Adha, Here, one mole of zinc loses 2 electrons to become Zn plus 2. 1 mole of Cu plus 2 gains 2 moles of electrons. Therefore, number of electrons exchanged will be 2 there. Number of electrons exchanged between zinc and copper ions will be 2. Agagi 0.0591 by 2. And of course, log to the base 10 of molar concentration of products. Products are the molar concentration of products. Zn plus 2. You should write Zn plus 2 in square bracket. That square bracket indicates what? Molar concentration. Now the Zn plus 2 in square bracket is molar concentration of Zn plus 2 ions into molar concentration of copper, another product. How that? But copper is a solid. You know, molar concentration of solids will be taken as 1. Agagi adanna ili product alli bariyodilla nanu. Iga divided by reactants andaga, that is molar concentration of Cu plus 2 ions. Molar concentration of Cu plus 2 ions reactant alva into molar concentration of zinc, that is also solid. And as I said, molar concentration of solids will be 1. Hagagi ili nanu 1 anta bariyodrinda avaddanu nanu bariyak hogodilla. Hagagi this is last equation for, yes it is, overall reaction that is taking place in Daniell cell. E reaction ke, this is the last equation. E naught of cell andre enada standard cell potential. E naught of cell enada standard cell potential adu gothiye nimge. That is E naught of cell is equal to, that is E naught of cathode minus E naught of anode. Copper is a cathode, zinc is a anode. Adalva, so this is what we call it as last equation for the reaction that is taking place in Daniell cell. Agbodalla? Yes. Now let us see question number 7 now. One more question, that is one more question, that is question number 7 appeared in March 2017 question paper. Okay na? In it already. Write the mathematical expression for limiting molar conductivity of sodium chloride. You know that according to Kohlrausch law, limiting molar conductivity of electrolyte is equal to the sum of the limiting ionic conductivities of cation and anion. With respect to the sodium chloride solution, right? Sodium chloride solution contains ions like Na plus and Cl minus ions. Limiting molar conductivity of NaCl, that is lambda m of NaCl, that is lambda m naught, yes it is lambda m naught of NaCl is equal to lambda naught of, yes it is Na plus ions plus lambda naught of, yes it is Cl minus ions. Limiting molar conductivity of electrolyte sodium chloride is equal to sum, you know that plus we are written sum and then addition, sum of the limiting ionic conductance of cation and anion. Yes, your NaCl produces one Na plus ion and one Cl minus ion. Hagagi lambda naught of Na plus is a limiting ionic conductance of Na plus, lambda naught of Cl minus is limiting ionic conductance of Cl minus. This is the mathematical expression according to Kohlrausch law, and that is for limiting molar conductivity of sodium chloride. Yes, agbodalla? Yes. Adre ondu gamanisbeku, I am using capital lambda for electrolyte, I am using small lambda for ions. Idun gamanisu, capital lambda idu namge hege A B capital A small A antidira athara Latin literature alli this is capital lambda, this is small lambda there. Okay na? This lambda for electrolyte, this lambda for ions. Adanna svalpa gamana ittkobeku. Okay na? This is mathematical expression. Yes. Now let us see the question number 8 there appeared in July 2017 question paper. Yes. Write anodic reaction taking place at hydrogen oxygen fuel cell. You know, in fuel cell you will find two reactions. One will be at cathode, another will be at anode. And here in this question you are supposed to answer, you are supposed to write the reaction that is taking place at anode only. You may go to that. At anode compartment, hydrogen gas will be oxidized in presence of OH minus ions from potassium hydroxide solution. Yes, that leads to the formation of water with the loss of electrons. With the loss of electrons, right? You know that one mole of hydrogen loses 2 moles of electrons and becomes 2H plus ions. 2H plus ions combined with 2OH minus ions to form 2 moles of water there. So this is a reaction that is taking place at anode there. Yes. Next one. How many Faradays of electricity required to reduce 1 mole of permanganate ion? Permanganate ion is written as, yes it is, MnO4 minus into Mn2 plus ions. I am going to reduce permanganate ion into Mn2 plus ions. E reaction here. MnO4 minus will be converted into Mn2 plus ions. For this particular conversion, how many, yes it is, Faradays of electricity is required. And for that purpose, you know, you have to write, yes it is, reduction of permanganate ions into Mn plus 2 ions. First two, reduction reactions in a paribetu, yes. Reduction takes place in presence of H plus ions. And all the four oxygen atoms are converted into, yes it is, 4H2O there. All the four oxygen atoms will be converted into 4H2O there. Again, number of hydrogens is 8, agate, hagagi 8H plus agate, yes. And in order to balance the charges, ekade plus 2 charges are there. Ekade plus 7 charges are plus 8 minus 1 agate, plus 7. And of course, here plus 2, here plus 7. To make it plus 2, you know, you add 5 electrons here. How that? Because reduction involves what? Yes, it is addition of electrons. Hagagi, in order to balance the charges, ekane total charge on the reactant side is plus 2. Total charge on the product side is also plus 2. Charges balance aayitu. Equation balance aayitu. How da? Ege nodi. E base, idhru basis mele. Nani nirubudhu yata. 1 mole of permanganate gains 5 moles of electrons. Therefore, quantity of electricity Q is equal to the charge, yes it is, of 5 moles of electrons. Quantity of electricity is equal to what? Charge of 5 moles of electrons. You know, charge of 5 moles of electrons is 5 Faradays. Actually, charge of 1 mole of electrons is 1 Faraday. Charge of 5 moles of electrons is 5 Faradays. Illi, 5 moles of electrons irodrinda. 1 mole of permanganate consumes, athwa gains 5 moles of electrons to become Mn2 plus ion. Because of that, we need 5 Faradays of electricity. We need 5 Faradays of electricity for converting 1 mole of permanganate ions into 1 mole of Mn2 plus ion. So this is what we call question number 9. Appeared in the year March 2018. Yes. Next one. Question number 10. Appeared in July 2018 question paper. Yes. Why does conductivity of solution decreases with the dilution? Yes. Question number 10. Why? Conductivity andre kappa, it's also known as specific conductance. We go to the effect of dilution on conductivity. As dilution increases, conductivity decreases, molar conductivity increases. Namik helirudu conductivity athwa specific conductance yakandre on dilution number of moles of ions per dm cube decreases. Is the answer. Upon dilution, number of moles of ions per dm cube decreases. Therefore, conductivity decreases. Molar conductivity, lambda m is equal to kappa into vm. How the? On dilution, kappa decreases. But lambda increases. On dilution, kappa decreases. But increase in volume more than compensates decrease in conductivity. Therefore, molar conductivity increases. Adre nimik helirudu conductivity matra yakendre on dilution number of moles per dm cube decreases. Therefore, conductivity decreases. Nimishte barbekagirudu number of moles of ions per dm cube decreases. Therefore, conductivity decreases, right? That is question number 10. Appeared in July 2018 question paper, right? Next one. Question number 11. Appeared in March 2019. Yes? Draw a graph of lambda m, molar conductivity versus square root of concentrations versus square root of C for weak electrolyte, that is a stick acid. And of course, for a stick acid solution. You know that you already studied that graph, yes? the plot of lambda m, molar conductivity, yes, along y axis, don't forget to write origin 0, yes, and of course square root of, yes, it is C there, yes, along x axis, concentration increases, along y axis, molar conductivity increases, for weak electrolyte, you know, this is the variation, yes, this is the variation, and of course, you know, this will not touch the y axis, so this is what we call it as, yes, it is variation of, yes, it is, that is molar conductivity against concentration for weak electrolyte like acetic acid, yes, for weak electrolyte like acetic acid, how that, you know, weak electrolyte, yeah? Strong electrolyte, yeah? Akasmat ide prashne, strong electrolyte, yes, you know this, this is for strong electrolyte, yes, this is the variation in molar conductivity with concentration, yes, as concentration increases, molar conductivity decreases with respect to strong electrolyte like KCl. Strong electrolyte ee riti variation agutte, weak electrolyte ge ee riti variation agutte, yes. And ondu gamanisbeku, ee line idiyalla adu y axis ge touch maadakoddu, adre idu nodi ee tara extend madidre touch agutte illi, but idu touch agodilla, aa point anna neevu correct aagi gamanisbeku, appi tappi ee line anna idu touch maadabardu, yes. So this is what we call it as variation of molar conductivity versus concentration, yes. So this is what we call it as effect of concentration on molar conductivity in the case of weak electrolyte like acetic acid, strong electrolyte like KCl, yes. This is nimige bari acetic acid kelodudrinda idond graph anna baradre saaku, jothege origin ivella graph baradirtira, origin ne baradirala, avella sans sans mistakes correct aagi note koli, okay na. So this is what we call next, yes. This question appeared in March 2019. Question number 12 nodi, state Faraday's first law of electrolysis appeared in July 2019 question paper, yes. State Faraday's first law of electrolysis, you know Faraday's laws, they are going to establish quantitative relationship between masses of the substances liberated and quantity of electricity passed. How that? According to Faraday's first law of electrolysis, the mass of the substances liberated or deposited at the electrodes during electrolysis is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity passed. That is, if I say W is the mass of a substance liberated or deposited at the electrode during electrolysis, is directly proportional to quantity of electricity passed through the solution of electrolyte. So this is what we call it as Faraday's first law of electrolysis. And of course, this is question number 12 appeared in, yes, it is July 2019 question paper. Just a statement as to in Baribeko, the mass of a substance liberated or deposited during electrolysis at the electrodes is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity passed through the solution of electrolyte. Astana. Okay na? So this is what we call it as, or you can say mathematical expression, you know that W is equal to ZQ, or you can say ZIT, you know that Q can be replaced by IT, electric current and time there. Okay na? This is electrochemical equivalent. Z is what? Electrochemical equivalent. So this is mathematical expression for first law of electrolysis, right? Faraday's first law of electrolysis, right? Now let us see question number 13. Yes, it was appeared in March, yes, it is 2020 question paper. It was appeared in March 2020 question paper, yes. How many Faradays of electricity required to reduce 1 mole of dichromate into CR3 plus ions? You know, we already discussed reduction of permanganate into Mn plus 2. Again, let us see reduction of dichromate, Cr2 oscillant 2 minus in presence of H plus ions. Reduction involves what? Yes, it is gain of electrons. Reduction, electrons will be gained and dichromate will be changed to, yes, Cr3 plus ion. And here, oxygen will be converted into water there. That is 7H2O agate, yes. MnO4 minus L, hege. We converted all the oxygen atoms into water, salva hage. All 7 oxygen atoms will be converted into water. 7H2O and 14 hydrogen atoms. Therefore, you need 14H plus ions. Cr2 irodrinda, 2 Cr3 plus varibeku, yes. E kade nodi, total charges in there. Minus 2 plus 14, plus 12 with it, ikkada isthide plus 6 ide illu plus 6 aagbeku illu plus 6 aagbeku adikoskara en martini 6 ana add martini hage enaitu total charge on the reactant side is plus 6 total charge on the product side is also +6. The equation is balanced. On the basis of this equation, what I can write? That is 1 mole of dichromate, yes? 1 mole of dichromate, how the? Cr2O7 minus 2 gains, really? 6 moles of electrons, how the? 6 moles of electrons, how the? 1 mole of dichromate gains 6 moles of electrons, and of course, quantity of electricity Q is equal to charge of 6 moles of electrons, that is 6 faradays. Charge possessed by 6 moles of electrons is 6 faradays, and really? Faradays are killed, you can stop here only. Q is equal to 6 faradays. 6 faradays of electricity is needed for reduction of 1 mole of dichromate into, yes, it is Cr3 plus ions. Okay, na? Yes, 6 faradays. Akasmat coulomb sir kelidre into 96,500 coulombs anta badre aitu. This is question number 13, appeared in, yes, it is March 2020 question paper. Okay, na? In the question number 14 idiyala, that was appeared in July 2020, and that will be what is secondary cell anteli. Adhe question, first question now discuss madidalu adhe prashne July 2020 alli kuda kelidare. Yes, that is what is secondary cell anteli, that we already defined. Okay, now so these are the 14 questions from 14 question papers from 2014 to 2020, and all questions are 1 mark questions asked in question number 3 in part A of the question paper. Yes, agbodala? Yes. Now we'll go to the part B question. Yes, 2 mark questions, section 2. Now I'm going to discuss all 14 questions appeared in 2014 to 2020 question papers, right? And this question is question number 12, is it not? This is question number 12 in part B. We'll see first one. What is molar conductivity? How is it related to the conductivity of a solution whose concentration is C mole per meter cube? You are supposed to relate molar conductivity with conductivity, that is. I want to establish a relationship between molar conductivity with conductivity of a solution with a concentration C mole per meter cube. This is very important. The relationship between lambda m, molar conductivity and conductivity, depends on the units of concentration. Agagi, these units of concentration are correctly observed. Because first one, what is molar conductivity? You know, conductivity of all the ions produced by 1 gram mole of electrolyte in solution. Astane. Molar conductivity and conductivity of all the ions produced by 1 gram molecular mass of electrolyte in solution, that is called as molar conductivity. Conductivity of a solution due to ions produced by the dissociation of 1 mole of electrolyte in solution, that is called as molar conductivity. How is it related to the conductivity of a solution if its concentration is C mole per meter cube? That is kappa divided by C is the relationship. Kappa divided by C. Lambda m is equal to, yes, it is 1000, yes, into kappa divided by m. And of course, we have lambda m is equal to kappa divided by 1000 into m. Concentration C mole per meter cube ithaga. ಇದನ್ನೇ ಬರಿಬೇಕು ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಕಪ್ಪ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಮನ್ ಪರ್ ಮೀಟರ್ ಅದು ಗಮನಿಸಿ ಕಪ್ಪ ಸೈಮನ್ ಪರ್ ಮೀಟರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರಬೇಕು ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಪರ್ ಮೀಟರ್ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ಇರಬೇಕು ಆಗ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಇದು ಬನ್ನಿ ಯೋರ್ ಎಂ ಈಸ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಪರ್ ಡಿಎಂ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಮೊಲಾರಿಟಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಎಸ್ ಕಪ್ಪ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಮನ್ ಪರ್ ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಕಪ್ಪ ಸೈಮನ್ ಪರ್ ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಮೊಲಾರಿಟಿ ಮೋಲ್ ಪರ್ ಡಿಎಂ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಅಂದ್ರೆ kappa is in, yes it is Simon per, yes it is meter there, kappa is in Simon per meter, and molarity is of course mole per dm cube, molarity mole per dm cube ide hagagi gamanisbeku yav units alli ide antu helibittu. Okay na, ee units alli idre this is the formula for relationship between molar conductivity and molarity athwa concentration. Ee units alli idre this is the relationship. अकस्मात सी इफ द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इज इन मोल पर मीटर क्यूब दिस इज द रिलेशनशिप नमगे कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इन मोल पर मीटर क्यूब ಅಂತ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಐ ಶುಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ರಿಲೇಶನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡಾ ಎಂ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಕಪ್ಪಾ ಬೈ ಸಿ ಕಪ್ಪಾ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಎಸ್ ಅದನ್ನ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಗಮನ ಇಡಬೇಕು ಈ ಒಂದು ಡಿಸ್ಕಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಮಾರ್ಚ್ 2014 ಎಸ್ ಇನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಓಕೆನಾ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬನ್ನಿ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಎಸ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಜುಲೈ 2014 ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕರೋಷನ್ name the method to prevent it antide 2 mark prashna what is corrosion anadakke 1 mark name the method used to prevent the corrosion adukku 1 mark ide okay na one method idida saaku sumar methods ide one method idida saaku yes corrosion andre spontaneous destruction of a metal due to the combined action of air and moisture present in the atmosphere on the metal surface that is called as corrosion athwa spontaneous deterioration of metal due to the combined action of moisture and air on the surface of a metal that is called as corrosion yes and of course name the method used to prevent it andaga you can write any method like barrier protection ante ide barrier protection barrier protection alli painting baruthe painting is one of the methods of barrier protection second that is sacrificial method ant barutha sacrificial method ant barutha idralli sacrificial method alli galvanization barutha yes third alli that is cathodic protection ant barutha cathodic protection ant barutha this is one more method that is fourth method is what we call it as electroplating ant barutha yes electroplating yes these are the methods that we can go for preventing corrosion of a metal on this particular aspect you can also expect question like this name the general methods for the prevention of corrosion anta kelabodu name the general methods for the prevention of corrosion anta helidre ide barebeku barrier protection sacrificial method cathodic protection and electroplating yes these are the four methods that you can go for preventing corrosion of a metal what is corrosion of a metal a spontaneous destruction of a metal due to the combined action of air and moisture on the surface of metal is called as corrosion of a metal you know corrosion of a metal is generally oxidation reaction or you can say it is electrochemical phenomenon avda right next question the third question appeared in March 2015 question paper yes state first law of electrolysis already we stated for the electrode reaction what quantity of electricity in coulombs required to deposit one mole of zinc ಅಂತ ಇದೆ ನೋಡಿ first law of faraday's first law of electrolysis already now discuss ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ that is the mass of a substance liberated or deposited during electrolysis is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity passed through the solution of electrolyte ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ In the question itself, no, the reaction is given. For this reaction, yes, Zn plus 2 plus 2 electrons, and that gives, yes, it is Zn. This is reduction of Zn plus 2 ions, athwa deposition of zinc metal during electrolysis. For this particular reaction, what is the quantity of electricity required to deposit? Well, yes, it is 1 mole of zinc. Equation aur ek kottidara, yes. Jothege, you are supposed to decide quantity of electricity in coulombs alli kelidara. Howda? Hagagi, nodi. Quantity of electricity is what? This is a charge of 2 moles of electrons. Actually, it's a charge of 2 moles of electrons. Actually, 1 mole of Zn plus 2 consumes 2 moles of electrons. Hagagi, the quantity of electricity is equal to the charge possessed by 2 moles of electrons. That's equal to 2 faradays. Charge of 1 mole is 1 faraday. Charge of 2 moles of electrons is 2 faradays. 2 into 96,500 coulombs. And that is what we call it as the quantity of electricity in coulombs there yes and it comes out to be 2 into 96,500 that comes out to be 193 yes 193,000 coulombs 193,000 coulombs is the quantity of electricity required to deposit 1 mole of zinc okay na istene idikke 1 mark irutte 193,000 coulombs inda baradik 1 mark irutte ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾರಡೇಸ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಸಿಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಒನ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಟೋಟಲ್ ಟೂ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್, ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಮಾರ್ಚ್ 2015 ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್. ಎಸ್, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಜುಲೈ 2015 ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್. ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ರ್ಯಾಶ್ ಲಾ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಫ್ಯಾರಡೇಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲಿಸಿಸ್. ಎರಡು ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಬರೀಬೇಕು, ಒಂದು ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ರ್ಯಾಶ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಮೈಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಫ್ಯಾರಡೇಸ್ ಲಾ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲಿಸಿಸ್. ಫ್ಯಾರಡೇಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲಿಸಿಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟೆಡ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ರ್ಯಾಶ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಮೈಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ರ್ಯಾಶ್ ಲಾ, ದ ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೋಲಾರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ದಿ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಯೋನಿಕ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅನಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಈಚ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈಡ್ ಬೈ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಒನ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ರ್ಯಾಶ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಎಸಿಟೀಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಮೈಗ್ರೇಷನ್. ಫಾರ್ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಟೈಪ್ ಎ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಬಿ ವೈ ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಟೈಪ್ ಎ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಬಿ ವೈ, ಎ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅಯಾನ್, ಬಿ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಅನಯಾನ್. ಹೌದಾ? ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೋಲಾರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್ ಎ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಬಿ ವೈ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಯೋನಿಕ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅಯಾನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ವೈ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿ ಈಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್. ಹೌದಾ? ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೋಲಾರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಬ್ಡಾ ಬರ್ತಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೋಲಾರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ದಿ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಅಡಿಷನ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಯೋನಿಕ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಯಾನ್ ಎ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ವೈ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ಯಾಟಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅನಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಮೈನಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಅನಯಾನ್ ಈಚ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈಡ್ ಬೈ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಒನ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್. ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್, ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಬಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ವೈ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ರ್ಯಾಶ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಮೈಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್. ಬಟ್ ನಿಮಗೆ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಇಷ್ಟೇ ಬರೀರಿ, ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೋಲಾರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ದಿ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಯೋನಿಕ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅನಯಾನ್ ಈಚ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈಡ್ ಬೈ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಒನ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ರ್ಯಾಶ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಮೈಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್. ಆಗ್ಬೋದಲ್ಲ? ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಜುಲೈ 2015. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲಿಸಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಗೈನ್. ಎಸ್, ನೌ ಕಮ್ ಟು ದಿ ಫಿಫ್ತ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಮಾರ್ಚ್ 2016 ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್. ಎಸ್, ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಬ್ಡಾ ನಾಟ್ ಎಂ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಂ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್. ಎಸ್, ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಬ್ಡಾ ಎಂ ನಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಂ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಯೋನಿಕ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ Mg plus 2 ions and Cl minus ions is equal to 106 Simon centimeter square per mole and 76.3 centimeter square per mole. Yes, it is. Calculate limiting molar conductivity of magnesium chloride if limiting ionic conductivities of Mg plus 2 ions and Cl minus ions are 106 Simon centimeter square per mole and 76.3 Simon centimeter square per mole respectively. This is limiting ionic conductance of Mg plus 2 ion, limiting ionic conductance of Cl minus ions. By using this, you are supposed to calculate limiting molar conductivity of magnesium chloride. You know this magnesium chloride, yes, and that dissociates to produce, yes, Mg plus 2 ions and 2 Cl minus ions. 1 mole of magnesium chloride contains 2 moles of Cl minus ions, 1 mole of Mg plus 2. Therefore, lambda m naught of MgCl2 is equal to lambda naught of, yes, it is Mg plus 2 plus Mg plus 2, that is charge of, yes, it is magnesium, plus 2 into lambda naught of Cl minus. Yeah, 2 were there. There are 2 Cl minus ions produced by magnesium chloride. Lambda naught of Mg plus 2 is given there. 106 plus and 76.2 into 76.3 the simplification mari, that is Simon centimeter square per mole. Once again let me remind you, whenever there are units you are supposed to write the units properly. 2 into 76.3 yes plus 106, it comes out to be 258.6 Simon centimeter square per mole. That is, yes, it is answer there. Formula 1 mark, simplification with final answer with unit carries 1 mark. Sometimes if units are not written properly, 1 mark will be deducted. Okay, na? Okay, na? So this is what we call it as a calculation of limiting molar conductivity of magnesium chloride. As I said, this question appeared in March 2016 question paper. Yes. Next one, question number 6 there. What is secondary cell that we already defined? Write the equation for cathodic reaction of the lead storage battery. You know, lead storage battery is one of the secondary cells. How the? And you are supposed to write cathodic reaction matra. You know, cathodic reaction na kehta. That reaction that is taking place at cathode during discharging of lead storage battery. Discharging is the, when the battery is in use, when we are using the electricity from the battery, yes, then that is discharging there at cathode. That is PbO2 ions in presence of sulfate, yes, in presence of SO4 2 minus, in presence of sulfate, and of course in presence of H plus ions, and they take up electrons because cathode alone agutte reduction agutte, reduction alone gain of electrons, enagutte, you are going to get, yes, it is PbSO4, and of course all the 2 oxygen atoms will be converted into water there, that is 2H2O, hagagi number of hydrogens which are to 4, that is 4H plus, so this is ಈಗ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಲ್ವಾ. ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ, ಯುವರ್ ವಿ ಹಾವ್ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 2 ಚಾರ್ಜ್, ಯುವರ್ ವಿ ಹಾವ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ 4 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 2 ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹೌದಾ, ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಇಂಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ 2 ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್. ನೋಡಿ ಏನಾಯ್ತು, ಈಗ -4 -2 -2 -4 +4 ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್. ಅದೇ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ, addition of electrons ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, that is gain of electrons, that is cathodic reaction where reduction takes place. Anodic reaction ಅಂದ್ರೆ lead combines with SO4 2 minus and gets converted to PbSO4 and of course plus 2 electrons. This is the reaction at, this is the reaction at anode ಇದು, ಹೌದಾ, the lead storage battery during discharging where lead is losing electrons, your lead is gaining electrons, ಹೌದಾ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ lead plus 4 state ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ, plus 4 becomes plus 2 by gaining 2 electrons. ಇಲ್ಲಿ lead 0 state ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ, it becomes plus 2 by losing electrons. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ lead ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ lead peroxide ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಎಸ್, ಇದನ್ನ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಗಮನಿಸಬೇಕು. ನಿಮಗೆ ಕೇಳಿರೋದು ಇಷ್ಟೇನೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ 1 mark question. ಎಸ್, ರೈಟ್ ದ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲೆಡ್ ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜ್ ಬ್ಯಾಟರಿ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಡಿಸ್ಚಾರ್ಜಿಂಗ್. ಎಸ್, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಚಾರ್ಜಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಏನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ಕೊಡದಿದ್ರು ಕೂಡ ನೀವು ಡಿಸ್ಚಾರ್ಜಿಂಗ್ ಬರೀಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಅಕಸ್ಮಾತ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಇದನ್ನ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಷ್ಟೇನೆ, ಓಕೆನಾ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಡಿಸ್ಚಾರ್ಜಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಿಂಗ್, ಅಷ್ಟೇನೆ. ಚಾರ್ಜಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಈ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅನ್ನ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇನೆ, ಓಕೆನಾ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬನ್ನಿ, ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ನಂಬರ್ 7 ನೋಡಿ. ಮಾರ್ಚ್ 2017 ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಈ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಯನ್ನ. ಎಸ್, ರೈಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡಿಕ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆನೋಡಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಲ್ ಸೆಲ್. 2 mark ಕ್ವೆಶನ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಆನೋಡಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಲ್ ಸೆಲ್. ಎಸ್, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ಆನೋಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೇಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆನೋಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಗೋಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ OH- ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಗೆಟ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ವಾಟರ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿತ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ 2 ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್. ಹೌದಾ, 2 ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ 2H ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಲೂಸಿಂಗ್ 2 ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್. 2H ಪ್ಲಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಂಬೈನ್ ವಿತ್ 2H- ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ 2H2O. ಹೌದಾ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಟ್ ಆನೋಡ್. ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಅಪ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್. given by hydrogen and get converted into, yes, it is OH minus ions. Cathode alli electrons gain agutte, anode alli electrons loss agutte. Hauda illi, yes, it is idinenadru neevu 2H2 ant barkondre hydrogen 4 agutte, oxygen 4 agutte, aga 4H OH minus agutte. 4 minus irodrinda 4 electrons beke beku. Hauda ಎರಡು ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಓವರ್ ಆಲ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ 4 ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ 2 ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಎರಡು ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈಡ್ ಬೈ 2. ಹೌದಾ, ಹೌದಾನೆ. ಓವರ್ ಆಲ್ ಇಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಬಾಡ್ಬಿಡಿ ಮತ್ತಿನೇನು. ಹೌದಾ, ಇನ್ನೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ನೋಡಿ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 2H2 ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಹೌದಾ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್. ಹೌದಾ, ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್. ಹೌದಾ, OH minus ions ಇನ್ ಅಕ್ವಿಯಸ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ. OH minus ions will be in ಅಕ್ವಿಯಸ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ. ಹೌದಾ, ವಾಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಇದೆ. ಹೌದಾ, ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಅದನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಬರೆಯೋದು ಬೆಟರ್. ಎಸ್, OH minus is in aqueous medium. ಹೌದಾ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ 2H2 4OH minus 4OH minus ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಕಾಮನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್. ಹೌದಾ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಇದೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್. ಹೌದಾ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ 2H2O ಇದೆ, 4H2O ಇದೆ, ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಉಳಿತದೆ, ಯು ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ ವಿತ್ 2H2O ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟ್ ಸೈಡ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ 2H2O ಇದೆ, ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ 4H2O ಇದೆ, ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಉಳಿಯೋದು 2H. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಓವರ್ ಆಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್ ಸೆಲ್. ನಿಮಗೆ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಆನೋಡಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆನೋಡಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ 1 mark, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ 1 mark. ಇದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಎರಡು ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಓವರ್ ಆಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಬರ್ತಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಕೆಲವು ಸಾರಿ ರೈಟ್ ದ ಓವರ್ ಆಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಇಷ್ಟನ್ನು ಮಾತ್ರ ಬರೀಬೇಕು. ಎಸ್, ಓಕೆನಾ. ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡಿಕ್ ಆನೋಡಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಕೇಳೋದ್ರಿಂದ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್, ಗೈನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆನೋಡಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್, ಲಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆನಾ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ 2017 ಮಾರ್ಚ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್. ಎಸ್, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬನ್ನಿ. ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಜುಲೈ 2017 ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್. ಎಸ್, ರೈಟ್. ಸಾರಿ, ಲ್ಯಾಂಬ್ಡಾ ಎಂ ನಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ NaCl, HCl ಅಂಡ್ CH3COONa ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಅಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆರ್ 126.4, 425.9, 91 ಸೈಮನ್ ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ಲಿ. ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಬ್ಡಾ ಎಂ ನಾಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್. ಯುನೋ, ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಡಿಟರ್ಮೈನ್ ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೋಲಾರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ವೀಕ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್ಸ್, ವಿ ಮೇಕ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ರಾಸ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಮೈಗ್ರೇಷನ್. ಲ್ಯಾಂಬ್ಡಾ ಎಂ ನಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ CH3COOH ದಟ್ಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಲ್ಯಾಂಬ್ಡಾ ನಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಸಿಟೇಟ್ ಅಯಾನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಬ್ಡಾ ನಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ರಾಸ್ ಲಾ. And therefore, lambda m naught of, yes, it is acetic acid, yes, that's equal to, yes, you know, this can be produced by, yes, yes, it is lambda m of sodium acetate that is given there. How the sodium acetate put it there, then? You know the limiting molar conductivity of sodium acetate that is produced, that produces acetate ions plus lambda m naught of HCl. How the HCl ಆಗ್ತೋಣ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ HCl ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ಎಚ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್. ಹೌದಾ, ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ದಿಸ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಅಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ಅಸ್ಟೇಟ್, HCl ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ಎಚ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್, ಬಟ್ ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ Na ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ Cl ಮೈನಸ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್. ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು Na ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು Cl ಮೈನಸ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೋಲಾರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ NaCl ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಯು ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೋಲಾರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್. ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೋಲಾರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಅಸ್ಟೇಟ್, HCl ಅಂಡ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅಷ್ಟು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸಾಕು, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೋಲಾರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಅಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ, 91.0 ಇದೆ, ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೋಲಾರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ HCl ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ, 425.9 ಇದೆ, ಅದನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮೈನಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೋಲಾರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ NaCl ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 126.4 ಇದೆ, 126.4 ಇದೆ. ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೈಮನ್ ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಆಲ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಮನ್ ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಫೈನಲ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಕೂಡ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಸೈಮನ್ ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿ, 91 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 425.9 ಮೈನಸ್ 126.4, ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ 390.5. Simon centimeter square per mole. This is what we call, that is calculation of limiting molar conductance of, or limiting molar conductivity of acetic acid by knowing limiting molar conductivity of corresponding strong electrolytes, sodium acetate, HCl and sodium chloride. ಹೌದಾ? ಇವೆರಡು ಅಸಿಟೇಟ್ ಮತ್ತೆ H+ ಅನ್ನು ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅವೆರಡನ್ನ ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನಮಗೆ Na+ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ Cl- ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಬೇಕಾಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಸಬ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಮೈನಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಬ್ಡಾ ಎಂ ನಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ NaCl ಅಂತ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಎಸ್, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬನ್ನಿ, ಡ್ರಾ ನೀಟ್ ಲೇಬಲ್ಡ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್ ಸೆಲ್, ರೈಟ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್ ಸೆಲ್. ಆಗ್ಬೋದಾ? ಅದನ್ನ ಬರೆಯೋಣ. ಬರೆದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಯು ಆರ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಎಸ್, ಲುಕ್ ಯುವರ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಸ್ಕಿಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಲಬ್ಸರಿಯರ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಒನ್ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಲಿಂಡ್ರಿಕಲ್ ವೆಸಲ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿ ಟೂ ಪೋರಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಡ್ಸ್ ಕಂಟೈನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲಾಟಿನಮ್. ಎಸ್, ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಇನ್ಲೆಟ್. ಎಸ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕಂಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವೇರ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆನೋಡ್ ವಿತ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್, ದಿಸ್ ಅ ಕಂಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೀಂಗ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕರೆಸ್ಪಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸೆಲ್, ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್. ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟೂ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಡ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಪೊಟಾಷಿಯಂ ಹೈಡ್ರಾಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ಸ್ K+ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ OH- ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್. ಹೌದಾ? ಆಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಕ್ಟ್, ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಹೌದಾ? ನೀವು ಆಟೋಡಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದರ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್. ಹೌದಾ? ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಇಸ್ ದರ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್. ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪಾಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡಿಕ್ ಕಂಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್, ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್, ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್, ಎಸ್, ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಅಪ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಬೈ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಆನೋಡ್. ಎಸ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಲೀಡ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ OH- ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ ಲೀಡ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ OH- ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್. ಹೌದಾ? ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ 2H2 ಅಂತ ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಫೋರ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆಗ ಫೋರ್ OH- ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅಕ್ವಿಯಸ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ. ಎಸ್, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಫೋರ್ OH- ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಫೋರ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಬರೆದ್ರಾಯ್ತು. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್. ಎಸ್, ಕ್ವಶನ್ ನಂಬರ್ 10 ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಜುಲೈ 2018. ಡ್ರಾ ನೀಟ್ ಲೇಬಲ್ಡ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ಓವರ್ ಆಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ. ಎಸ್, ಇದೇ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಒನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ರೈಟ್, ಇದೇ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಬರ್ದ್ರಾಯ್ತು. ಓಕೆನಾ? ಎಸ್, ಓವರ್ ಆಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಟ್ ಆನೋಡ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಟ್ ಆನೋಡ್, ದಟ್ ವಿ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್. ಓವರ್ ಆಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಬರಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಆಡ್ ಬೋತ್. ಎಸ್, ಎರಡನ್ನ ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಆಯ್ತು. ಟು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ದಿಸ್ ಇಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಬೈ 2, ಇದನ್ನ ಎರಡಿಂದ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, 2H2. ಹೌದಾ? 2H2 ಗ್ಯಾಸ್. ಹೌದಾ? ಅಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ O2 ಗ್ಯಾಸ್. ಹೌದಾ? ಇಲ್ಲಿ 4OH- ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಎಸ್, ಫೋರ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ 2H2 ಇದೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ 4H2 ಇದೆ, ಉಳಿಯೋದು 2H2 ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್. ಎಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಓವರ್ ಆಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್. ನೀವು ಇಷ್ಟು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸಾಕು. ಓವರ್ ಆಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ 2H2 ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ O2 ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ 2H2 ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್. ಇಷ್ಟು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸಾಕು. ಎಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೀಸ್ 1 mark, ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೀಸ್ 1 mark. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಓವರ್ ಆಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಇನ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್ ಸೆಲ್. ಎಸ್, ಕ್ವಶನ್ ನಂಬರ್ 11 ನೋಡಿ. ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಮಾರ್ಚ್ 2019. ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾರಡೇ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲಿಸಿಸ್ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ. ಎಸ್, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ, ಮೈಕಲ್ ಫ್ಯಾರಡೇ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೂ ಲಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಪಾಸ್. ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಲಾ, ವೆನ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್ಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಸಿರೀಸ್, ದ ಮಾಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು ದಿ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆನಾ? ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ಯಾರಡೇ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲಿಸಿಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ವೆನ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್ಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಸಿರೀಸ್, ದೆನ್ ದ ಮಾಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ಡೆಪಾಸಿಟೆಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು ದಿ ದರ್ ಈಕ್ವಲೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಸಸ್. ಹೌದಾ? ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಸಿ ಟೂ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್ಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಸಿರೀಸ್ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ, ದ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ W1, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಸ್ E1. ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಇಸ್ W2, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು ಇಟ್ ದ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಸ್. ದೆನ್ W1 ಬೈ W2 ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ವಾಟ್? E1 ಬೈ E2. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ mathematical expression for, yes, it is second law of electrolysis. W1 is the mass of a substance, first substance. W2 is the mass of a second substance. Equivalent mass of the first substance, equivalent mass of the second substance. So that is when same quantity of electricity, our word very important, when same quantity of electricity is passed through different electrolytes connected in series, the masses of the substances liberated or deposited is directly proportional to their equivalent masses. Okay, na? So that is so that is what we call a statement. Ke matra 2 mark ide. Okay, na? Just a statement. Ke. Ille mathematical expression bharadi antu helila. Hagagi statement baradre saaku, you are going to get 2 marks there. Yes. Now let us see. Question number 12 appeared in July 2019 question paper. Yes. Question number 12 appeared in July 2019 question paper. Draw a neat labeled diagram of standard hydrogen electrode. Write its Hopf cell reaction. Something there. That is, we have a diagram of standard hydrogen electrode. Yes. Amele. Ali cell alle nadithakkanta kelavu Hopf cell reactions anna neevu baribeku. Okay, na? We'll see that diagram, right? Look here, this is a schematic picture of the standard hydrogen electrode, where this standard hydrogen electrode can be constructed by passing hydrogen gas through one molar solution of HCl under 1 bar pressure at 298 kelvins, of course, where HCl solution is in contact with platinized platinum foil. This is a platinum foil. Foil adha tagadu. Platinum foil coated with finely divided platinum. In order to give rough surface to the platinum foil, you know, the foil is coated with platinum black. Here you can say finely divided platinum. Yes. Okay, now this is a glass tube in which platinum wire is fused. This wire is welded to the platinum foil dipped in 1 molar HCl solution. This particular glass tube is covered by means of outer jacket through which, you know, hydrogen gas passes through the 1 molar HCl solution. This diagram alli neevu 1 molar HCl dorisbeku, finely divided platinum coated with platinum foil. Idu correct aagi mention maadbeku. Hydrogen gas under 1 pressure anta mention maadbeku. Okay, na? This is outer jacket. Yes. This yellow line idira, that is platinum wire welded to the platinum foil. Okay, na? Illodi bubbles idira, that is excess hydrogen that is going out in the form of bubbles, because you need to maintain a pressure of 1 bar. Hagagi that excess hydrogen gas has to escape through the solution in the form of bubbles. So this is what we call it as the schematic picture of standard hydrogen electrode. Agbadala, that is one mark prashne. Okay, na? Inondu, you are supposed to write Hopf cell reactions, you know, that as far as working of hydrogen is concerned, it can act like a anode as well as cathode. You got it? Yes. If it acts like a anode, yes, hydrogen, okay, gas, it will be oxidized to, yes, it is H plus, half H2 gas oxidized to H plus with the loss of one electron. That is, if it acts like anode, oxidation of H2, half H2 into H plus takes place. If it acts as a cathode, reverse agata, H plus in aqueous medium will take up electrons and gets converted to half H2 gas. That is reduction at cathode. These are the Hopf cell reactions. If SHE and the standard hydrogen electrode acts as anode, this is a reaction. If it acts as a cathode, this is a reaction. Okay, na? If you have 1 mark, this diagram is 1 mark. Total, yes, it is 2 mark question. Yes. And then we'll see question number 13. This question number 13 was appeared in March 2020 question paper. Yes. March 2020 question paper only. This question is about that. Yes. So let us see that the next question, question number 13, appeared in March 2020. Yes. A solution of nickel nitrate is electrolyzed between platinum electrodes using a current of 5 amps. We are going to pass a current of 5 amps, right, through the nickel nitrate solution for about 20 minutes. Time is equal to 20 minutes. Okay, now. What mass of nickel is deposited at cathode? You are supposed to calculate mass of a nickel deposited when 5 amps of current is passed through the nickel nitrate solution. Look at this. Nickel nitrate solution contains Ni plus 2 ions. Formula ne helutte nodi. Ni NO3 twice anta irodrinda, twice 2 is the charge of nickel. Ni plus 2. Yes, it is. Will take up 2 electrons and gets converted to, yes, it is nickel solid. This is reduction of nickel plus 2 ions into nickel. That is deposition of nickel ke e reaction. Okay na? According to this equation, look at this. One mole of yes, it is nickel. E equation prakara, one mole of nickel is produced when 2 moles of electrons are consumed. 2 moles of electrons in 2 into 96,500 coulombs of electricity is passed. How that? 2 moles of electrons in 2 into 96,500 coulombs. Secondly, 1 mole of electrons will have a charge 96,500 coulombs. 2 moles of electrons irodrinda, that is 2 into 96,500 coulombs of electricity is required for depositing. Yes, it is 1 mole of nickel. 1 mole of nickel is 2, that is 1 mole of nickel corresponds to atomic mass of nickel, that's equal to yes, 58.7 gram per mole. This is atomic mass. On the basis of this, what I can say that 2 into 96,500 coulombs of electricity is required to deposit, yes, it is 58.7 grams of, yes, it is nickel. How the? This is the quantity of electricity required to deposit, yes, it is 58.7 grams of, yes, it is nickel. How the? But as far as our problem is concerned, Q is equal to IT. You are supposed to calculate quantity of electricity passed through the electrolyte for 5 amps. I is a 5 amps. Time is 20 minutes. That has to be converted to seconds. 20 minutes is equal to what? That is 20 into 60 seconds. Yes. Then multiply. We are going to get, yes, it is quantity of electricity in coulombs, that is 5 into 20 into 60 there, that comes out to be 6000 coulombs. And then passing 5 amps of current for 20 minutes, and you are passing 6000 coulombs of electricity. In order to deposit 58.7 grams of nickel, you need to pass 2 into 96,500 coulombs of electricity. What about for 6000 coulombs, and 6000 into 58.7 divided by, is it 2 into 96,500 coulombs. So the 6000 into 58.7 divided by 2 into 96,500 coulombs, that is in terms of grams there. Simplify money, we are going to get the answer. Yes, comes out to be, look at this, 6000 into 58.7 divided by 2 divided by 96,500 coulombs. It comes out to be 1. Yes, it is 824 grams. 1.824 grams. That is the quantity of nickel deposited when 5 amps of current is passed through the nickel nitrate solution for about 20 minutes. Means 1200 seconds. 5 amps are given in the 6000 coulombs. Know that? So this is how you can calculate the things. Okay, na? So this is 2 mark question. Yes, it is. That is, it was asked in the year, yes, it is March 2020 question paper. Yes. Question number 14, Nodi, appeared in July 2020. What is the effect of decreasing concentration on conductivity and molar conductivity? What is the effect of decreasing concentration? And then dilution. As concentration decreases, conductivity decreases. Okay. Due to decrease in number of ions per dm cube. But molar conductivity increases. On decrease in concentration of solution, molar conductivity increases, because when concentration decreases, volume increases. That more than compensates decrease in conductivity. Therefore, as concentration decreases, conductivity decreases, molar conductivity increases. Illi reason kelilla. Isthen ivare bekagirudu. Decrease in concentration decreases conductivity, increases molar conductivity. Athwa decreases kappa, increases lambda m. Avada? So that is what we call it as question number 14, appeared in, yes, it is July 2020. So these are the 14 questions appeared in part B, that is question number 12 of the question paper. Avada?
So next it will be part D there, 5 mark questions from 2014 to 2020. That we'll see in the next video, right?